Hi everyone, I'm Nevin.
I'm Mel.
And I'm Moendi. Welcome to episode 3 of KASA, and Mel will be telling us what KASA stands for.
Yeah, KASA is an abbreviation for Kibera Aeronautics and Space Academy.
So today we'll be having various topics to discuss on. One is on the education system, or how it can be designed to encourage and inspire and produce more scientists.
For sure. Neville, you had something before we discussing the first topic.
On what?
Icebreaker or something. Just before we start.
Nice. So I think we will start with a fun fact about space. Okay. So if you guys can share a quick fun fact about space. Maybe I'll go first. One fun fact. Many space enthusiasts have the idea that there's probably aliens lying somewhere in the universe, just hibernating, waiting for when the conditions it will be right to come out. And what's this?
Wait first. Oh, which is true?
Yeah, it's arguable. Like,
first, you can tell me your definition of aliens. What is alien to you?
An intelligent being that is outside of Earth, that hasn't originated from Earth.
No. Alien?
I would say alien, same this definition, it's kind of an intelligent being that has originated from another solar system or somewhere else apart from Earth.
And
yeah,
I thought you to watch it. Alien, it's anything like unknown. It can be outside Earth, it can be inside Earth, but it's anything unknown. So, if a rock, it's on Mars and it's unknown. Honestly, that's a
so that's a lesson that I've learned today, so I never knew that. So, I would say a fun fact about space is the sun is very heavy.
Yeah.
So it's 99% of the our solar system. 99% is by mass. I mean by mass, sun is 99% heavier than anything else on our solar system. So that means it's really huge and it's really heavy.
So for me, I'm not all that about space, but I know. Which I'm not sure of, so I'm saying the fact, but I know the sun can accommodate more than 1 million Earths. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's only about sun, but it's a huge number. So, yeah.
Nice to know. Yeah, so for the first topic, we are going to discuss how education system can be designed to encourage and inspire more scientists. I mean, science is really a nice field of study, and we need to inspire more people to get into the field to help us understand the universe and space. You know, without scientists, we could have not known how sun works, how the Earth works, and maybe how we can get to Mars, like what Elon Musk is envisioning. So how can we inspire more people to get into the field? So that's what we want to discuss. So any ideas?
Off the top of my head, I think the education system should have the learners to be more involved. Mm. Yeah, rather than having someone come and deliver what they know, it should prompt more curiosity from the learners.
Mm.
And encourage them to give ideas.
Yeah, so do you mean more practicals?
Before we even get to practicals, a more inquisitive-led form of learning, where, for instance, the instructor presents a topic and a background of the topic, and then the learners are encouraged to come up with ideas on the same topic. And then afterwards, everyone can discuss that topic.
Yeah, so what I get from your point is how the current education system has not focused much on creativity.
yeah, I wouldn't say creativity, I would say inclusion of the learners.
Okay. Yeah. Engagement of the learners.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly, that's the right word, engagement of the learners.
Okay, so I'll go back to my previous point about creativity. So I think science is more of, like, if science is a topic where everybody can be right.
Yeah.
No? Yeah. So it's about proving. So I don't think the current education system focuses much on creativity or making the students to make things work. Mm-hmm. So it's about imparting them. Right now, I see the education system is that is just imparting facts,
yeah,
about science, but there's no like a way of making the students to explore beyond what they are being taught in classes. So I would like to see an education system where students are given equipment and they are told to do whatever they can do with the equipment. So whether it's building, if it's building rockets, there's not only one way of building rockets.
Yeah.
So we want to see how creative the students can be in learning or how to, or using the equipment or what they're given to come up with new ideas. Yeah. Wendy, do you have anything related to?
So for me, I think it's all about the roots.
Mm.
I think the education system like should start all about space and everything from the lower classes.
Mm.
So I'm not sure, but NASA conducted this type of research whereby most of it was like rating the geniuses. So most of the geniuses rate, which was like 99%, was between the age of 0 to something 14. So of which adults, the rate of genius was, let's say, 14 to 13%. So maybe if we can start the classes or the system, the education system, from the roots. Someone to grow, learning all about space, everything from, yeah.
Yeah, you are really right. So that's something that I'm also thinking about. So most of, as a young person, for example, someone like me, I was really interested in knowing how the universe works and trying to challenge the facts or the customs and the traditions of my tribe and where I come from. But, you know, that eagerness to question and to always want to make things happen, like it died with time. So to me, I blame the education system because I didn't get a clear path of motivating me, keeping me motivated throughout the journey. So the education system, most of what we are being taught right now, some of them are really not useful. So making the education system to focus more on encouraging and inspiring the students or the learners in what they really want to do. So if someone like me who wanted to know more about the universe, I could have been taken directly to a class full of people like me who would like to know how the universe works. Now that environment will help me grow and learn more about what I'm interested in, instead of taking me to a class where I'm learning about things that are not related to the universe.
Also, guys, as you may have heard in the background, there's some rain in the background. We are sorry for the low quality sound. Yeah, so from my point of view, there's still a couple of topics that have to be introduced into the education system, especially on personal life, finances, emotional stuff, positive psychology, how to be happy, how to relate with other people. There's still a lot of discussion relating with the education system, which I'm really interested in seeing how that unfolds.
Yeah, you know what's funny? The current education system was set in 1800s, and it was set to suit the needs of the people who are working in the industry. Then, like, the people working in the fields, actually, the foragers, and people are working in factories and stuff. Now the world has changed. Now the problems or the topics that we are really interested in knowing how to, is knowing how to live a happy life.
Yeah.
About emotional intelligence. Someone like me, one of the greatest things that I actually say I ever did was attending a 10-day meditation retreat. So including something like meditation or how to master your emotions into the education system will really help a lot of people, kids or learners, to grow as good people, not just academically, like physically, emotionally, and spiritually. So to me, I would also like to see how incorporation of the current challenges that we are facing into the education system. We need to pay more attention to topics related to global warming, topics related to space exploration, definitely. Topics that are really affecting us in this current generation.
Yeah, this is a really broad topic, as you guys might have noticed. So we're willing to engage more about the same. If you guys have any ideas, you can share with us in the comments. Also, as KASA, we are trying to fix the problems that we ourselves have faced, and we are setting up a program to train kids in space exploration, and along the same lines, technology and other skills that they may apply in their lives.
Yeah, right now we are doing a campaign, right?
Yeah.
So we are doing a campaign to buy equipment and also to help us with the development of the courses, what Neville just said, creating the courses that will educate the learners about space exploration and how to use space exploration technologies to make the world a better place. So right now we have raised $102 out of our targeted $3,500. So if you are someone who believes that kids from Kibera and any other corner of the world should be given equal opportunities to explore the world or to make their dreams of going to space or making space related projects happen, then you can consider contributing to our campaign, and we will share the link in this video.
Sure. Cheers, guys. Thanks for joining us. Let us know how we can improve these videos and how we can make them more engaging and informative. Bye.